Hey guys, and welcome back. If you are new, thank you for joining and welcome. This is actually the first part of painting the cabinets. If you watched any of my other videos preparing the kitchen, you will see that I tried to paint the cabinets white, and then we decided to go a different color that I think is going to look way better. I know this video is later than when I normally post them, but for the past, this past week has been super, super busy, guys. 3 baseball practices in this week, and then doctor's appointments. My daughter had her 1-year well child check, and she got shots, and if you have young kids, you already know what that is like, trying to get anything done. And I always have to work in between her because what she wants is what she gets. And the color, it doesn't actually show on camera the color that it is. It has like gray undertones because if, I don't remember if I said it in, I'm pretty sure I have said it in other videos that the kitchen is going to go with like a gray theme because you see the kitchen floor, it's like the dark gray. But these cabinets, they're like a, I don't want to say they're blue. I mean, in some lights it does look more blue, but it's once it's got enough coats on it and once it's dry, it comes off more of a grayish. I actually show a picture, like a short little video of what it looks like in our little bathroom, because this is actually the color that is in our little bathroom, only I'm putting it on the cabinets instead of the wall. But anyway, I done lost track because I got distracted with the colors on the screen. This past week has been super busy, and it took me a while to even get this little bit up, and in this video you only see me do one coat and half of the kitchen. So there will be another part, you know, doing the other half of the kitchen and stuff like that. Plus I still have to paint the walls, but I was doing this in between juggling the baby, juggling baseball practice, doctor's appointments. My allergies have been kicking my butt this week because I have been out on my allergy medicine for a few days. So I've had a horrible headache. And I'm kind of stopped up and sneezing, itchy eyes, you know, the works. So I am trying to push through and get as much done as I can in the quickest way possible, guys. And if you see later on in the video, the cabinets and the sink or whatever has dishes and stuff, just know, guys, that I had to video and I had to paint in between everything, which means making dinner and baby needing a nap and everything else. So but anytime you do a big project like this or whatever, you have to work around everything. As you can see in a lot of this video, I was having to work around people in and out of the kitchen, my kids, my wife, you name it, the baby. Everybody was in and out of the kitchen, and trying to paint cabinets in a kitchen where there's a lot of people, it doesn't always go that way very well. But if you see at the bottom, like where like the, I guess like what you would call where the kick plate would go, if you see where I still left that brown and I didn't paint that, there is a good reason for that, guys, and that is because the it's kind of like rubber baseboard. That's the way that that's what I call it. And before I paint down there, I want to see how far the kick plate part, baseball, whatever you want to call it, I want to see how far up that comes up on the cabinet before I try to paint that. And actually what I'm using right here, it's actually liquid sandpaper, and I'm just wiping down the cabinets and stuff, getting any grease or whatever off. And I feel like this is still, I don't know, guys. I think, yeah, because I done the top cabinets first and then came down and started doing the drawers and stuff or something like that. Or either I started on one part because everybody was on the other side, and I don't know, guys. But yeah, you'll see me taking the, you'll see me taking the little handle thingies off and stuff. That way I can paint them better. As of right now, only one side of the kitchen is painted with the first coat. I still have to do the second coat, and I still have to do the other part of the kitchen, because like I said, I had to work around everybody and everything else. And if I would have done the whole kitchen in one sitting, there was bound to be somebody getting paint everywhere and brushed up against them and everything else. So I chose to go ahead and do this side of the kitchen, because this is the most frequented side of the kitchen, because this is where the dishwasher is, this is where the sink is, the stove, all that. So I decided to go ahead and get the hardest part out of the way. I put the first coat on this side of the kitchen, which I've got to do another coat. And it actually doesn't take very long to dry, guys, which was really surprising to me. And thankfully, so far, nobody has brushed up against it, knock on wood. Nobody's brushed up against it or made a mess or anything. So I figured I would get one side of the kitchen cabinets painted first, you know, the first coat and the second coat, and then I will take and move on to the other side of the kitchen. That way, hopefully, you know, there's not extra work involved by having to redo something or whatever. Because let's face it, y'all, I was not feeling this at all on any of these days, because this did take a matter of, I think it took more than 2 days. I can't remember how many days. It took this whole entire freaking week just to get this one side of the kitchen cabinets done, and that was just the first coat. And you'll see my outfit change. But yeah, I felt like just picking up the paint can and just throwing it all over the kitchen. Like, that's just the type of mood that I was in. I was actually trying to listen to a true crime podcast to kind of get in my own little world. But as you can see, I had one side of the earphones off of my ear because of the baby and the other kids, and every time I turned around, somebody was mom, 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 mom. So let's see. Oh, and there is a cute little, well, actually there's two cute little moments in this video, and one of them you will actually get to see one of our fur babies that you haven't seen before, and it's because she's usually hiding all the time, but you will see her because the baby knocked my camera over, and when the camera falls you will see the fur baby. And she's an old girl, that's for sure. She's really old. We've had her since my oldest son, who was 19, since he was like I want to say 7, 8, maybe younger, guys. So you'll see her. Her name is Sky. She's a little fluff ball, but yeah, you'll see that cute little I can't remember how far in the video it is when you see it, but I slow the video down that way you can see it. Because I thought it was so cute. See, you can see where I tried to paint the cabinets white right there. And guys, let me tell you, I don't know if it was the paint or what the heck it was, but it was peeling off the dang cabinet, and I was getting frustrated, and I said, you know what? White is a bad idea anyway, because of kids, and white gets dirty too easily, and you can see every daggone thing because the coffee bar and the island is white, which I'm trying to figure out if I want to paint those or not. I may not, just because I don't want the extra work. But then again, I might. Well, I'll just have to see after the rest of the kitchen is done to see if I want to leave them white or paint them. But I was using the liquid sandpaper to get this white off of the cabinet that I had tried to paint. And do you see that? Like, it literally, you could take your finger across it and it just came off without anything. No water, no nothing. And I don't understand. I really don't understand why. Because the paint that I am painting right now did not do that. It must have been that white paint or something. I really don't know. But yes, right here you can see how messy the countertops and stuff are. But again, guys, this right here, when I was painting, I'm pretty sure it was around dinner time. And I think this night, Ebony, or it might have been Mom that was cooking this night. Heck, I don't know. I could have had a crock pot meal on. I don't even remember. I can't remember nothing. But yeah, the cabinets and everything tends to get messy and everything. But later in this video, we had another freaking leak under the sink. So that was a nice mess, me trying to paint while under the sink was getting repaired and everything else. And that was lovely. But we did get that fixed. I think that's it, guys. I do show at the end the other part of the kitchen that still has to be painted. And I also do an overview of what one coat of paint on the cabinets look like. So, just know that I probably will not video me doing the second coat of paint on this side of the cabinet. Because, I mean, why would you want to see that again? I will just show I'll probably do the other part of the kitchen. I might make a video out of doing the other part of the kitchen. And then, maybe do like an overview of the full kitchen after all the coats of paint is on and stuff. I don't know how I'm going to do it, but as soon as I know, you guys will know too. And oh, these little top, oh my gosh, those little boards that are across the top of the cabinets that you don't see me painting, that is because if you remember in a video when I first started doing the kitchen, I had actually said that I hated those things and I wanted to take them off. Well, guess what, guys? We finally took them off. That is why I'm not painting them. I had my son go ahead, my youngest son, I had him go ahead and take them off. That way I could, you know, paint under them to where it looked right. Guys, I'm just staring at the back of my head. I know I look rough, and I do apologize. See, this is another night. Do you see how late I got started on this? Do you see? Look, it's like completely dark that day that I got started on this. This is like another day, and I had to wait until dark to get started. That's just the story of my life. But anyway, I can't even remember what I was going to say, y'all. I've done lost my train of thought. Oh, see, I'm starting on the other side of the kitchen. This is the night that I had the crock pot meal going. I had crock pot spaghetti going. That is a family favorite. But, yeah, I went ahead and done this. And once I get to the bottom cabinets, guys, you will see, like, under the stove, that there's like an open area that has like the dog food containers and stuff in. There used to be two big drawers there, but the drawers broke, so we decided to use that area as the storage for the animal food, which I have an idea of how I'm going to make that look better once I get everything in the kitchen done that I want done. And that little thing where like the hood range thing, the vent thing, whatever it's called that is above the stove, that brown part up there. I didn't paint that in this video because honestly, I don't know if I want to paint it this color or what I want to do with it. I really don't know. And honestly, I forgot to paint it, but at the same time, I got to look, and when I realized that I hadn't painted it, and I'm like, I don't know if I want to paint it this color. I don't know if I need to paint it something else to break it up. I don't know what I'm going to do. I'll probably paint it this color, and if I don't like it or if it doesn't look right or whatever, then I can always repaint it later on or something. But anyway, guys, I've talked enough. I will go ahead and let you guys watch the video. Please make sure that you like, share, comment, and subscribe. That way you can keep up to date on any other videos that I do post. And I think that's about it. But I hope you guys have a great rest of your weekend and a good next week. And I will catch you guys in the next one. Bye.
peacefully, but have you ever thought about you? Don't know.